Hi, I'm Dr. Jack West, medical oncologist in Seattle, Washington, and I wanted to talk about the clinical implications of the KEYNOTE-189 trial that was just presented at AACR 2018 and published in the New England Journal of Medicine by Dr. Lena Gandhi and colleagues. In my last video, I described the key information in terms of efficacy and tolerability of this study of chemotherapy with either pembrolizumab or placebo in a first-line treatment for non-squamous, non-small cell lung cancer, no EGFR mutation or ALK rearrangement, and anything along the spectrum of tumor PD-L1 expression. But now I'd like to turn to the issue of what this means for the various subgroups of patients who would be eligible for this. It's about a third of patients each who have PD-L1 expression less than 1%, 1 to 49%, or greater than 50%. So I'm going to describe my thoughts on each of these groups in separate videos. The basic design of the trial is shown here in the figure. It was cisplatin or carboplatin with pemetrexed in both arms, two-thirds of the patients having that combined with pembrolizumab, one-third assigned to placebo, and the arm that got chemo alone with placebo could cross over to pembrolizumab. About 50% ended up doing that. And the trial was highly positive for an overall survival benefit, but you can see that there was an enormous benefit really in the patients with high-level PD-L1. I'm showing here the response rate, progression-free survival, and overall survival for this high PD-L1 subgroup, and you can see dramatic differences, nearly a 40% difference in the response rate, a substantially higher progression-free survival, and a one-year difference in progression-free survival of about 30% between the two groups, and also a remarkable difference in overall survival favoring the arm with the chemo and pembrolizumab. So this is very nice to see, obviously a major benefit in this population, but it's worth bearing in mind that the standard of care in 2018 or even last year would not be chemotherapy alone for this population. The true comparator arm for this subgroup of patients with high-level PD-L1 is pembrolizumab monotherapy, which is based on the results from the KEYNOTE-024 study that was presented and published in late 2016 and directly compared in patients with high PD-L1 expression in their tumors, compared pembrolizumab to histology-appropriate doublet chemotherapy. That study showed a very substantial improvement in overall survival as well as improvements in response rate, progression-free survival with pembrolizumab, and this led to the FDA approval very shortly after the publication for pembrolizumab, and we've never looked back. We have widely adopted pembrolizumab monotherapy as the optimal first-line treatment for these patients. And so having chemotherapy with pembro is another option to consider, but not necessarily a clearly superior choice. Dr. Roy Herbst highlighted the options and showed the curves for KEYNOTE-024 and KEYNOTE-189 subgroup with high PD-L1 side by side. And you can see the one-year overall survival was just over 70% with monotherapy, not a big difference, just 73% or so with chemo and pembrolizumab in KEYNOTE-189. So you could argue that yes, it's better, but on the other hand, with the chemotherapy added, you have all of the attendant side effects of chemotherapy, and you have the additional expense as a first-line therapy, potentially with maintenance pemetrexed and pembrolizumab, two very expensive drugs for a long period of time. And I would say that in most cases, just one of these drugs is going to be doing the heavy lifting, but you won't necessarily know which one. At the same time, you lose the option of a salvage regimen in the second line setting of platinum-based chemo that is preserved with pembrolizumab as monotherapy. So we're going to get some more information about how well this group performs with pembrolizumab monotherapy from the KEYNOTE-042 trial. I'm showing the schema for this here. And we know this is a positive study for an overall survival benefit. It is a very similar trial design to KEYNOTE-024, pembrolizumab versus doublet chemo, squamous or non-squamous histology. And the requirement was for 1% or higher PD-L1. So it's just a more liberal trial design than KEYNOTE-024. We'll see how much of a benefit and how big the overall survival is in the highest PD-L1 subgroup with pembrolizumab monotherapy. But I think that the true question that we would love to be able to answer is taking patients with 50% or greater PD-L1 and directly comparing carbo-pem pembro to pembrolizumab monotherapy as first line with the ability to cross over and see whether concurrent is better than sequential or not. In the meantime, I am generally inclined to favor pembrolizumab monotherapy for most of my patients who are eligible with a high level PD-L1. And I will consider and probably favor the chemo pembro arm for patients who are really in a tailspin, marginal performance status, where I feel like I have a very limited opportunity to get a good response, or I'm going to lose that patient and maybe not have the opportunity to cross them over to a subsequent line of therapy. But I think that's a minority, perhaps 10 or 20% at most. So those are my thoughts, but there are certainly a range of perspectives here, and I'd love to hear yours if you can like, comment, subscribe, and add any thoughts you have to the page where you find this. I'd be very interested in responding if I can. So in the next couple of videos, I'm going to turn to the other subgroups with 1 to 49% PD-L1 or less than 1%. Hope you find this helpful. Take care.